This channel is all about Revit, and with that, it's all about BIM, or Building Information Modeling. Now, in the BIM community, we like to claim that CAD is history and we don't need anything except for Revit. But in reality, it's not so simple. BIM is simply not just Revit. In reality, it's a whole process where we're going to be encountering many different programs and many different file formats. CAD formats are still a big part of the BIM system, and a lot of data that gets brought into the whole BIM ecosystem is some form of CAD. This is why I believe that CAD is not the past or something that is outdated, but rather its position has evolved into a support role in the terms of data and documentation management in the wider BIM system. So speaking of CAD, let's discuss what do we actually need from CAD software and which one is the best option. This brings us to the topic of today's video, which is ZWCAD. ZWCAD offers everything you need from a CAD software in today's BIM ecosystem. It's affordable, simple to use, powerful in terms of the features that it offers, and most importantly, it's extremely fast. ZWCAD has major advantages in terms of drawing flexibility and accuracy in the pre-design phase and site plan related work. In the design development phase, capabilities that can be applied to a variety of specific design and drawing tasks, such as deepening detailing. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you the brand new ZWCAD 2025 version and some of its most impressive new features. We're going to be talking about the speed and efficiency upgrades, how to convert images into vectors, point cloud improvements, as well as GIS improvements. Let's go! And before we continue, full disclosure, this is a sponsored video. So when it comes to ZWCAD, speed and efficiency are two of the most important parameters, and it was quick in the previous versions. However, in the new ZWCAD 2025 version, everything is taken to another level. So as you can see here, when it comes to PDFs, improvements are quite huge, 9x on the import speed, and then also when it comes to underlay panels, panning and zooming. So when you have a large PDF opened up and you want to kind of pan around, zoom around, well, that's going to be happening a lot faster now. And then we have some improvements when it comes to opening large 3D drawings, 3D wireframe, shaded and so on, and other formats. Something that I also find really impressive and really important is the point cloud conversion. Point clouds are usually massive files. They're really important in the industry today. So having CAD software that can actually manage them quite quickly is a real benefit. Now let's explore the new features, and for that let's jump into ZWCAD. And here we are in ZWCAD, and the first feature that I would like to show you is the image to vector. So basically bringing in an image into ZWCAD and converting it into actual CAD vector lines. So to do that, you need to go here to the Insert tab, and here we need to bring in the actual image. So let's click on Attach. Here I'm going to pick this topography map with contour lines, which I only have in an image form, and I would like to convert this into actual contour lines. So now I'm just going to hit Open, and then here we have some image settings which we can set up. I'm fine with this one, so let's just click OK, and now I'm just going to place it here like so. So when it comes to converting this into a vector, let's type in a command, vectorization, but we also have this vectorization options. So I'm actually going to bring this up first. And here, as you can see, we have a list of options. So let's go here to contour, click on edit, and here you can see all of the options that we have, which we can customize for general and then both for fit. And here we can play around with these parameters to get the best results. Now let's click OK and close out of this menu. And now let's try again. And here I'm just going to click on vectorization and pick this command, select the image. And as you can see, it's already done. Everything has been converted. Now here we have the question, do you want to modify the vector graphics? I'm just going to go with no, no need to do that. And then, yeah, let's continue. And now if I select this image, hit delete, There we go. So now, as you can see, this has been converted into a CAD format and it looks really, really good. Now, in the beginning of this video, I've mentioned that CAD has an important role to play as kind of a support role in the whole BIM process. So for example, in this case, we could take that topographical image file, convert it into CAD lines here in ZWCAD, and then we can even select them and orbit around like this, and then I can select these individual lines and then I can assign elevation. So for example, for this one, I can assign an elevation of 10 or something like that, or even 100. And then this one we can place perhaps at 90. And then with this process, as you can see, we can build this topography in 3D. And by doing that, then we can bring this later on into Revit, convert it into a topo solid, and continue from there. Now we come to my favorite part of this video, which is point clouds. So I think point clouds are the future. They're really amazing, but they have an issue where they're really extremely large files and managing those files can be difficult. Luckily, ZWCAD is really quick when it comes to this. So let's test it out. So I'm just going to go here to the insert tab and then let's find the point cloud panel and click on point cloud attach. Once we do that, it's going to open up a folder where we can select our point cloud. I'm just going to pick this one and hit open. Here we have some options. So we have the name of the file, and then we can either specify on screen the position, or we can manually type that out here if we want to kind of coordinate it in a specific way. And then we have some additional options in terms of the scale and rotation and so on. So I'm happy with the current settings. So I'm just going to click OK. And then I'm going to click here to place my point cloud. And here it is. And of course, at any point, you can move it around if you want, place it somewhere else, and so on. So anyways, now let's take a look at this point cloud. So as you can see, the presentation is really, really good. The point density is quite nice. We can see this facade very well. The colors look great. And now we can start exploring it. So currently we're seeing scan colors. So basically, as the camera would be capturing this building, we're seeing those colors. However, we can change the presentation of individual points by selecting the point cloud, going here to visualization. And as you can see here, we have scan colors. So basically colors from the scan. Now we also have object color, which is just going to represent this as any other geometry. In this case, it would look white like that. Then we have normal, which is just going to be showing you kind of different perpendicular planes with different colors. So that's how this looks. Then we have the elevation, which is really interesting. In this case, it's kind of showing you basically kind of level gradation. I think this is really useful in case where you have a site that was scanned as a point cloud. This would essentially show you kind of the contours of that site, which would be really, really useful. And then, as you can see, we have some other ones, but I'm just going to stick with scan colors because I prefer that presentation type. Another thing that I would like to show you is the section option. So us architects like to think in elevations, sections, and floor plans, and you can do all of that by using the section panel here. So in this case, let's look at the options. So I'm just going to go here to the top option. And then when I select this, as you can see, it's basically cutting our building from the top. Now here we get this little arrow. We actually have two, but this one is basically going to be moving that along the vertical axis, allowing you to kind of pick the point where you want to cut the building, just like this. And then you can see, yeah, there's the cut. And then the other arrow is basically just going to flip that around. So are you keeping the top? Are you keeping the bottom? And so on. So basically, this is the option for that. So it looks really, really good. Now, if I just hit the escape key a couple of times and select this section, what you can notice is that we have some options here on the modify panel. So we can have this as a plane, but we can also have it as a slice. So it can just be kind of slicing through the building, creating a kind of small slice there. And what you can do with this is you can go here to section line extraction. So what this will do is basically allow you to select that point cloud, and then it's going to generate line work or actual vector lines, CAD lines, according to this slice that we have created. So here, if I go and set this, yeah, let's use the current layer, and yeah, let's go with this green color, perfectly fine, use lines, that's okay, create, and as you can see, it has created these lines. Of course, you can fix them up or change them however you like. But if your goal is to scan a building and then create some floor plans, this is going to save you a lot of time. And then if I just select this again and hit delete, it's going to remove that. However, we're going to keep our lines at that position and we can use them for kind of further work. Now let's talk about the enhanced GIS functions. So for that, let's go here to GeoService, and here we can easily assign our coordinate system by searching for it here. So I'm just going to search for the coordinate system I want to use. I'm just going to pick this one. We can set the drawing units here. I'm going to leave them as meters, but you can pick whatever you prefer. And then let's click on a point. So now once we have the coordinate system assigned, then let's add some data. So I'm just going to be linking my map service. So here you can input your URL and then you can just click OK. So it's going to open it up here. And then I'm just going to import this so I can check my design and see if everything is fitting in correctly how I want it to fit. We can also check our coordinate system here, so we can make it geographic or absolute, so you can exchange that here. Now, apart from linking your map service, you can also use maps within ZWCAD. So if I go here to add map, as you can see, we have quite a selection, including Bing map, and then I can pick the one that I want to use, click OK. So now it's going to overlay that Bing map, and we can use that in order to kind of geo-reference our designs. And that's going to conclude this video of checking out the new features and improvements of ZWCAD 2025. Now, if you would like to test it out for yourself, I'm going to be leaving a link to a free 30-day trial up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Something else to keep in mind is that ZWCAD provides a perpetual license, so it can help you save money and solve the issue of pirated software. So feel free to test it out and see if this is the best CAD software for your needs. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.